Well, despite weeks of protesting, even some as early as just yesterday, Governor John Kasich signed Senate Bill 5 into law today.
Well, now it's time for the changes to begin. News 5's John London joins us live now to explain the new workflow for local firefighters. John?
Yeah, Curtis, now that the governor has put his John Kasich to Senate Bill 5, one of the serious and significant questions is who will set the staffing level for fire trucks like the ones inside the Coryville station here. Under the new way of operating, that won't be a bargaining item.
There's nothing retroactive in the collective bargaining reforms. As labor contracts expire, new rules will kick in.
We're going to be fighting the fires from outside more often.
To firefighters, it's a staffing and safety situation intertwined. Currently, by contract, firefighters run 4 to a truck, but once May 2012 rolls around, the city could lower it to 3 without negotiation.
They are allowed to negotiate for safety equipment. We don't want to put them at risk.
Republican Lou Blessing supports the new restrictions, says it should be a government call answerable to the voting public at large.
The reason for that is these aren't private employers, they're public employers. And it's up to the public to decide how much money they spend on anything.
Today's New York Times analysis piece puts Ohio at the forefront of reform. The headline heralds it as tougher than Wisconsin. Governor John Kasich now in the lead position as the high-ranking face of reform.
I hear an argument for working class and middle class. I'm middle class.
Chris Littleton says with 12% of the population unionized and half of that in public employee unions, labor needs to get a grip.
So to think that if that was removed, it's somehow the world is going to end is just fundamentally flawed.
However, there's other fundamentals. Firefighters aren't supposed to enter a burning building to save someone unless there's at least 4 of them at the scene.
And tonight, clarification about when the bill takes effect. It's not immediate. It would be in 90 days. And what if labor gets this matter on the ballot? Well, if that happens, we'll take a look at the ramifications tonight at 6. Live in Coryville, John London, News 5.